In 2002, amateur astronomer Bill Young found what he thought was an asteroid. However, as astronomers tracked it, they found that it was in an unusual orbit. It turns out this asteroid wasn't an asteroid at all. After doing some special observations, scientists discovered that the asteroid looked to have parts that were covered in the white paint NASA used to paint the Saturn V rockets. It was part of the upper stage of Apollo 12 Saturn V rocket from 1969 that took the second group of astronauts to the lunar surface. So what happens to the parts of a rocket that don't make it into space? Rockets are made up of several different parts, and over the years, those parts have evolved with changes in technology. The rockets people are most familiar with are those developed by NASA and their contractors to take people to the moon and the International Space Station, and that launch satellites into orbit. In the 1960s, NASA developed the Saturn V rocket to take the Apollo astronauts to the moon. That rocket had three stages. This means that the Saturn V rocket had three large parts to it. Each contained its own engines and propellant. After each stage did its job, it broke away, with some pieces falling back to Earth and ending up in the ocean, like the recently recovered F1 rocket now on display in the Destination Moon Gallery at the National Air and Space Museum. After Apollo came the Space Shuttle, a partially reusable spacecraft. The Space Shuttle consisted of two solid rocket boosters, an external tank, and the orbiter, which many people remember as the space plane. Like the Saturn V rocket, each stage broke away once its job was completed. Unlike the Saturn V, the shuttle's rocket boosters were retrieved from the ocean and reused. The orbiter landed like an airplane and was also reusable. And the external tank burned up in the Earth's atmosphere after the fuel had been used. The idea of reusable parts continues today. Many of today's rockets are reusable, even having stages that come back and land on Earth where they will be reused for a future launch.
Let us know what you thought of this video down in the comments section. And if you enjoyed it, be sure to give it a like and a share. And follow STEM in 30 on Facebook and Twitter, and subscribe to the National Air and Space Museum's YouTube channel.